Hello, it's Eric Backer, naturopath from New Zealand, author of Candida Crusher. Thanks for checking out my video today. I'm going to talk a little bit about dysbiosis, gut dysbiosis. So I often get asked questions by patients, you know, regarding this nature. What are beneficial bacteria? What are probiotics? What are prebiotics? And the question today is, what is gut dysbiosis? I want you to think of your digestive system really containing an incredible amount of bacteria, lots of different bacteria. In fact, it's estimated to contain between 1 to 1.5 pounds of bacteria. That's trillions and trillions of bacteria of many different kinds of species. So try and think of your digestive system like being a garden with all different kinds of plants in the garden, trees and shrubs and weeds and grasses and all sorts of stuff. And in and amongst all that, you're going to have lots of different insects and things living in there. So it's quite a massive ecosystem. And it's the same with your gut. So there are different parts of the digestive system that will contain different types of bacteria and in different populations. A lot of it depends on the pH or the acidity and alkalinity of that area. So the stomach is quite acid-forming compared to the colon or the large intestine, which tends to be a little bit more alkaline. So dysbiosis commonly affects the small and large intestine. Lactobacillus species of beneficial bacteria populate the small bowel quite a lot, and the bifidobacteria populate the large bowel. You'll have both of those species living throughout, but that tends to be where a lot of them live. Dysbiosis occurs when you're going to get an influx of bad bacteria and yeasts and even parasites, you know, in these kind of areas. And that can occur for a whole multitude of reasons. A common reason, for example, may be after taking one or more courses of antibiotics or PPI drugs, we call proton pump inhibitors, you know, stuff for like acidity in the stomach. You may have also taken courses of non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs or NSAIDs. And this could be something like diclofenac, for example, for like arthritis. So pharmaceuticals commonly cause gut dysbiosis and leaky gut, which is a, you know, something a little bit different. So gut dysbiosis, how do you know you've got this gut dysbiosis? Well, bloating, farting, burping, funny bowel motions, abdominal discomfort, constipation and diarrhea may occur. Irritable bowel syndrome can be part of gut dysbiosis. Lots of patients I see have gut dysbiosis. So if you can relate to symptoms like that, like bloating, farting, you know, having bowel motions at weird times of the day or all over the place, skipping a day, not having a bowel motion one day, but having the next day, you know, these are all potential reasons, causes there, you know, from, you know, obviously for different reasons. But you can sort of get the picture what gut dysbiosis is. Dysbiosis, so, you know, life not so good. So the whole thing we want to do is cultivate the inner garden and get the beneficial bacteria to be there in larger amounts and to decrease the population of the bad bacteria. You'll need to watch some of my other videos where I talk about beneficial bacteria and also prebiotics and probiotics and eating the right kind of foods that contain the right starches and fibers and sugars that feed up these really good bacteria. So that gives you a bit of an insight into what gut dysbiosis is. Thanks for checking out my video today.